students, welcome to the class on current affairs, and in this class I will be dealing with a very important topic, definition of agriculture undergone change. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 3, plus this is important for geography and economics optional students. In order to understand this, we need to understand three issues about Indian agriculture. First of all, we need to understand the nature of agriculture economy in India, and then we need to understand how agriculture sector is used to evade taxes . And lastly, we need to understand the new changes that has been done to the definition of agriculture. This definition has been expanded, and agriculturist, and this definition has been narrowed down. So let us start from the nature of the agricultural economy. Now, as far as India is concerned, since independence we have seen the role of agriculture. It was a heightened role, it had played a big role in moving forward the Indian economy. But when it comes to the condition of a farmer in India, an Indian farmer is generally a poor farmer. An Indian farmer is poor because the agricultural practices, the way the agriculture is being practiced, it is more or less subsistence based. It is only after the Green Revolution that we have begun to see phenomenal improvement being taken place in the sector of agriculture. It's only after Green Revolution we have seen the productivity and the yield of the crops taking a jump. So broadly, because this sector is not considered to be very productive, this sector of the economy, that is agriculture, is not considered to be very remunerative, it is not considered to make one very affluent, and because this sector plays a very phenomenal role in the food security of the nation, this sector has been kept mostly out of the tax bracket, the tax net. So agriculture is a sector in the economy that is generally not taxed. About 80% of the spin-offs of the agriculture are not taxed in India. Now, why it is not taxed? Because Indian farmer is poor. Why it is not taxed? Because this sector supports the food security of the nation. Why it is not taxed? Because Indian agriculture is basically subsistence based, and the mass population is dependent on agriculture. This is the sector that employs the maximum population of the nation. Keeping all these factors into consideration, agriculture was not taxed. But this lacuna has been manipulated by the big farmers. The exemptions that were granted to the agriculture sector were used by the few and the rich agriculture groups in order to evade the taxes. So agriculture was used to evade taxes and to avoid taxes. There are n number of exemptions available over which, like, you don't need to pay taxes on the income that you have earned from agriculture sector. You need not pay any kind of service tax on agriculture sector, and such kind of exemptions have caused a huge loss to the exchequer. Now, in order to take this thing into consideration, GST Council has brought about a change in the definition of the agriculture. Now this change is about, it has brought certain products under the definition of agriculture, and it has narrowed down the definition of agriculturist. Agriculturist. Now what is meant by an agriculturist? Now agriculturist, according to the new definition, is one who directly engages in the activities of agriculture, who directly or through the servants or by the use of the labor or by the use of the family member indulges in carrying out the agricultural activity. So this is the definition of, the narrowed definition of an agriculturist. So what has been excluded? How this definition has been narrowed down? It has been narrowed down by excluding somebody who is leasing out the land, somebody who is giving away the land on rent to a tenant, somebody who is entering into a contract with a third party by giving away his or her land for a period of time. So if somebody is engaging in this contract thing, somebody is leasing out his or her land, in that case, the absentee agriculturists, they will not be treated as agriculturists. They will not be treated as the farmers. Only the directly, the people or a person who will be directly indulging in the activity of farming will be categorized as agriculturist. So anybody who is leasing or anybody who is not practicing this farming activity will not be called as agriculturist. And somebody is entering into this agreement and somebody who's given away the land will be liable to pay this GST, goods and service tax. So goods and service tax council has narrowed the definition of agriculturist, but in order to give a push to the agriculture sector, it has widened the definition of agriculture. Now this widened definition of agriculture, it not only includes farming, that is the sowing of the crops, raising of the crops, but it also includes horticulture, it also includes pisciculture, it also includes floriculture, it also includes collection of minor forest food products. So now the definition of the agriculture has been widened so that it can give push to this entire sector, so that it can help in alleviating the miseries of this entire sector. But in order to hit at how this sector is being used for the generation of the black money, it has restricted and constricted the definition of agriculturist. But like in India now, we have a situation of small holdings. The land is not, the pieces of land are not as big as they used to be during the independence era. In about 60 years, due to the division of the land among the family members, what we see, what we witness now, is the small land holdings. Now suppose I have a land of about 1 hectare and it is actually not feasible to do farming on the small piece of land. In that case, what I will be doing, I will be contracting, I will be giving away, I will be leasing my land to somebody else. So under the new definition of the agriculturist, I will be liable to pay GST. Despite I being poor, despite I holding a small piece of land, I will be liable to pay the tax. But the GST council has presumed that anybody who will be leasing out land would be rich. Anybody who is contracting or giving away the land would be rich, and he or she should end up paying GST. So this is something that is going to really hit the small farmers, the people who are holding small pieces of land. So in order to correct this change, what GST Council should be doing? Karna kya chahiye GST Council ko? GST Council ko ye karna chahiye, agar small pieces of land till 1 hectare, 2 hectare, 3 hectare or till 5 hectare hum lease kar rahe hain kisi ko, to wo exemption category mein aana chahiye. That should be again categorized as agriculturist. Agar jo lease pe le raha hai, agar uske paas 25 hectare, 40 hectare se niche ka land hai, 25 hectare se niche ka land hai, then that person should also be categorized in this category of agriculturist. Agar kisi ne 5-5 hectare leke hi 200 hectare ikattha kar liya hai, and somebody is indulging in food processing, in that case, it is that particular person who should end up paying GST. So this is the new change that has come, and this is a very substantive and the big change. Change about the taxes in the agriculture sector. Now the question that can be asked in your mains examination or in your interview, critically analyze the importance of the change done in the definition of agriculture and agriculturist. How the expanded definition of agriculture will help in improving the agriculture sector in India, and how restricting and narrowing the definition of agriculturist will help in amassing more taxes, but how it will end up hitting the small farmers who will be leasing out small pieces of land. Now if you want to read more on this, visit brainyias.com. You can also read Brainy map on the same topic. So this is all for the day. Bye bye, take care.